If you grew up in the 80s and 90s, you may remember, you should remember, we had some awesome-ass cartoons back in the day. G.I. Joe, Transformers, all the Disney cartoons, and I'm not even the biggest Disney fan, but I recognize those cartoons back in the day were freaking dope. And, you know, with all these popular cartoons everybody was watching, there was a ton of video game adaptations for the NES. Some were great, like most of the Disney licensed games for the NES were awesome. Who didn't love DuckTales and, you know, Chippendale's Rescue Rangers? Those games had the look and feel of their shows. The gameplay mechanics were good. The graphics appropriately resembled the characters they were portraying. These were titles fans of the show could pick up and complete without too much frustration and just enjoy their time. There were also plenty of other NES games based off of cartoons that were pretty good as well, like Bucky O'Hare, Felix the Cat was all right, and the G.I. Joe games. I think those were pretty good. Some, you know, they might have not been as polished or as great as the Disney titles, but there were some solid efforts for sure. Now, with all the great and just okay licensed games based off of cartoons, there were also a lot of just cheap cash-ins that completely sucked donkey balls. Today, I want to give you my top 5 picks for the worst NES games based off of cartoons. Remember, these are my picks, my own personal experiences. If you enjoyed or continue to enjoy the following games, nothing I say should take that away from you. But these games do fucking suck, so there's that. So the first game on my list, I have to say, is probably the least horrible out of my picks today, but it's still a stinker for a few reasons, and that game is Widget. So Widget was released on the NES in 1992. It was a little bit of a later release in the NES lifespan. It was developed by Graphic Research. Not sure how much research they did into what kids wanted out of a Widget game, but this is not it. This is not the definitive Widget experience, in my opinion. It was published by Atlas, so that's kind of cool, even though the game's not. Now, they did do some interesting things with this game, but it just fails to be a fun game. I remember watching this cartoon back in the day occasionally. Like, I wasn't glued to my television waiting for the next episode of Widget to come out, but occasionally I would catch it, right? It wasn't that memorable, and I'm just not sure if this game even captures the feel of the show. But minus that license, it's just a slog of a game. You move extremely slow. Some enemies, actually most enemies, are cheap as hell. And you only being able to shoot one bullet at a time definitely doesn't help things. So your projectile either needs to hit an enemy or leave the screen before you could shoot another. Stiff controls make the game a bit difficult at times to make jumps or avoid enemy projectiles. It's just so slow. I think this game, it tries to be like Mega Man a little bit with its execution of certain things, like gaining abilities after you defeat a boss and how they decided to design some of the enemies. The abilities, though, they're pretty lame. They're really only useful for very specific things. I guess they tried, but it's just a boring trek through a forgettable franchise that has numerous bugs and too slow a pace for its own good. Not the worst game by any means, but definitely not up to the standards of some of the cartoon licensed games that I mentioned earlier. So the next game on my list is another one I rented, not knowing what to expect, but hoping for the best, and that is the Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle. Now, if you accept that this game is really just a puzzle game without much you can actually do, then you might like it. But my disappointment comes in that I think this was one of the first Looney Tunes games I remember playing. It was wonky as hell. The AI of the enemies can hinder your progress due to blocking paths without any means of killing them. When a game forces you to kill yourself because there's nothing you can do, you know you're in for a good time. If only you could jump in this damn game, it wouldn't be an issue. Now, that leads to the controls, which really suck. I find it weird, but when you enter a door, you press up when it leads up and down if it leads down. Okay, I guess that makes sense. But also pressing up or down makes you move in whatever direction you are facing. This is not what I expected out of a game starring Bugs Bunny. Not much else to say about it. Don't like it. No, sir. Okay, so we gotta get to the worst of the worst and quick. So next on my list is yet another Looney Tunes game. I remember playing this one. I know I didn't buy this trash, so I had to have rented it or been duped into doing a swap with a friend. Remember them bastard kids who would offer to trade you a game and would hype the hell out of it, and then it turned out to be garbage, yeah, fuck them kids. So this game was one of those black cartridges from Tengen, not an officially licensed Nintendo game, and it shows it would not have deserved the Nintendo seal of quality anyway at that time. Roadrunner is just not fun. Originally, it was an arcade game made by Atari, which worked all right in that setting, but a weak port for a home console? Not so much. So you play as the Roadrunner collecting birdseed, trying to get to the end of the stage without Wile E. Coyote catching you or getting hit by obstacles. So you try to make a mad dash to the end of the stage, but you have to take it slow, which doesn't make it feel like you're playing as the Roadrunner. You get too close to the edge of the screen, you don't see incoming obstacles that can instantly kill you, like trucks and whatnot. The terrain does get trickier to navigate, and you easily get stuck on edges of things. And whenever Wile E. Coyote gets his rocket shoes, you have to stop progressing and just run in circles. I don't know, this game is just really lame. Okay, so on to the final two. These games are really bad. Not just games based off of cartoon licenses bad, but just bad NES games in general. Before we get to my last pick, we gots to talk about the Addams Family Pugsley Scavenger Hunt real quick. This was based off of the cartoon at the time. Shit, maybe this should be my top pick, but damn, this game seems like it was just some half-assed bootleg game straight out of China thrown onto one of those multi-carts. Oh my god, but this was yet another late release for the NES. It actually came out in 1993 from Ocean Software. I want to sound like I'm being fair, as this game also had a Super Nintendo version that came out first. So of course, it being a previous gen game, coming out after the fact, it probably wouldn't be as good as the Super Nintendo version, but there's just no excuse here. Slippery ass wet butt cheek controls, enemies just thrown everywhere without any reason, no music, no atmosphere. It's the Addams Family. Where the hell's the atmosphere? Where's the music? It doesn't make any sense. This game has less sound effects in it than most Atari 2600 titles, and it sounds worse. So what's the point of this game? It's pretty similar to the other Addams Family NES game, where you have to find the missing or kidnapped family members, but in this one, you play as Pugsley, the other one, you play as Gomez. But I just never really tried bothering finding any of these family members that went missing. It just seemed so uninspired and was just a huge mess. Where the fuck is Pugsley's eyes? He is dead inside just like this game. Okay, so I guess it's time for my final pick for worst NES game based on a cartoon. And this one, my god, it just pissed me off. Maybe that's why it's on top of the list, because it made me mad? Captain Planet and the Planeteers. I guess the point of this game may be to stop pollution or something, but I'm sure the game actually caused more pollution by being manufactured than it actually helped by trying to raise awareness. Screw this game. You start the game piloting some ship that keeps moving after you've stopped pressing the D-pad. You have to get used to that, I guess, but when the second you start the game, you cannot avoid the enemies and just barely getting clipped by something kills you, makes me want to do my part and throw the cartridge in the recycling bin. Now holy shit, every time you die and restart, the enemies are different or they're in different formation, constantly surprising you, giving you no chance to adjust to what just happened, because something different gets thrown at you every time. In all honesty, I didn't really give this game much a chance because of how it starts, but it just feels so uninspired, and it's the essence of a cash grab of a franchise people loved at the time. Did people actually love Captain Planet? I don't remember. I remember watching the show, but did people really love it? Did you love this game? I think this game is crap, dude. Like, I know it changes up after you get past the first stage, but yeah, there's just so many games like this. Not just cartoon games, but movie games. All those different tie-ins that just didn't do those franchises justice. And surprisingly, there's not a ton of cartoon-based games on the NES, but there is a nice handful, and probably half of them aren't worth even bothering playing. And I think these five games I talked about today, for me personally, are just not even worth my time trying to get back into. I tried. There's still even more, like, oh my god, The Simpsons, Bart versus the Space Mutants. That game sucked for various other reasons, but I didn't want to turn this into a huge list, and I didn't want it to be a big, like, review for each game. These are just the games that really, like, either pissed me off or just, I don't want to play them. like Bart versus Space Mutants, that game sucks too, but eventually I want to revisit it because I do have some nostalgia for it. These games, I played them back when they came out, and they suck just as bad now as they did then. Appreciate you guys watching. Peace out.